You guys, I'm gonna start a new experiment. I'm excited, more excited than normal because it involves getting more worms, which I know how bad that sounds, but technically I've been giving away a lot of my euros. I've had really good experiences giving them out to friends and strangers that are interested, and anyway, long story. So I'll just get to the experiment. I will show you exactly what I'm doing. The worms are not here yet, so I'm getting their beds ready. They should be here in a couple days. I am gonna do the Coco Coir versus cardboard. And I'm just trying to sort out in my head what's gonna work, what won't work, what I should be measuring, what I should be watching for. So any ideas would help. This one obviously took a lot more water. I don't think there's any way I could do the bedding weight by weight because this just saturated with water. It's going to be heavier. If I saturate this with water, it's going to be anaerobic. This seems to have more air in it. I'm probably not saying any of that right, but this includes shredded cardboard and cardboard egg cartons. Just kind of roughly broken up, as well as cardboard that's not shredded, just cut into, I don't know, 1 to 2 inch squares. So that's all that's in here. Sorry, along with the shredded cardboard, I've got shredded paper. And the paper is office paper. I really tried to make this as close to a home situation that you would normally find in someone's home, just to have, just what someone would find in their house, what someone would use for bedding. I'm not going to any crazy lengths to try any weird, like most of the cardboard is the base to my dog food, the canned dog food. It comes on little cardboard boxes and I always shred those up because again, we don't have recycling where I am. So I try to use everything I can and not put it in the garbage. Anyway, I have soaked this with water. It's damp, but not dripping, and it has a couple days to sit in, so I'll keep checking it. This was a brand new bin. It hadn't been used for anything. Both bins are identical, and I'm just going to try to, before I start, I'll make sure, I can weigh it, but again, that's something I would want feedback on. This is going to weigh a lot more, just because it's got so much moisture, so much water, but it's still too dry for them. So, just to make my scientific outcome as accurate as possible, I will take any advice that you have. I still need to add more water to this, but my idea was to fill them up so that they're about the same height in the bin. I think this guy needs a little bit more. But I've been really careful even just to brush my hands off before I go from one bin to another. I don't want any cardboard or paper products in here. I don't want any Coco Coir in here. I am going to add buffer to both before I put the worms in. I'm just gonna mix it in with the bedding and I will add the exact same amount. The food will be the same, the worms will be weighed out, and I will measure all of that when I'm done. I'm hoping to go as long as I can, like at least 6 months, maybe a year. I really wanna go for accurate measurements. And I wanna see what kind of castings I get. I wanna see which one uses up more bedding. I think it'll be pretty cool, pretty interesting, at least for me. I usually don't use coir because I feel like it kind of looks too much like castings. But I've heard a lot of good things too, so I don't know. I also know people who use both, so I don't think I have enough like space to do 3 bins and do one with both, but maybe I'll get adventurous. So let me know what you think and I will listen to you. I'm just getting my buffer ready and I thought I'd show you. I just have a third of ground eggshells. I just grind them in an old coffee grinder. This is azomite and this is dolomite lime, and I'll put links below. I just get them on Amazon. I really don't have a preference. But they come in a fine powder, so it works well. And then I just mix the three things together really well, and I use that as my buffer. So I'll measure those out carefully so that each bin gets the same amount. Okay, I do want to clarify before I add the buffer, you don't have to use all of those ingredients for buffer. You can use any one, you can use sand. I think Emily the Crazy Worm Lady is about to do a really cool experiment about buffer, so this is what I use. This is a mixture that I use probably because I'm paranoid and I use everything, so I just want to clarify, you don't have to use all three. I think I have these guys pretty even, but I have a couple days to check on them because I think this one's going to settle a lot and it might need more. It still doesn't weigh as much, even though I've added a lot of water. I probably added 75% to 100% if I were to guess. This takes a lot more water. So normally I just add buffer when I'm feeding, but these guys are getting buffer in there and they're bedding, and I'll mix this in really well. This is the exact scientific measurement of a laundry soap cup, just so you know. This is Science Dog 1, Science Dog 2, they're hard at work, dreaming up new things for me to try. So we shouldn't take this long to sprinkle. And then I'll just mix this in really well. Which you probably don't need to see. Okay, that's it for now. So I think they're all stirred up, they're ready for worms. I'll check on them again tomorrow I will check on them. Tomorrow's Thursday. I think the worms are coming Friday. Thank you, Emily. And if I have any interesting links or any songs I'm obsessed with, I'll put them below. So please tell me any ideas that you have. I'm willing to try anything. But I think this will be pretty cool. I'm excited. And even if for no other reason than if I'm the only one watching my videos and learning from them, I'm still happy. So thank you guys so much for coming, and have a good night, worm family.